All right, guys. So if we were in the normal classroom, we would be drawing from observation, aka we would be drawing each other. But since we are in a COVID world right now and we are learning virtual, we are going to be drawing from images of people. Now, if you do have a sibling or somebody you'd like to model for you when we get to our actual project, that would be amazing. But in case you don't, we're all going to start with one of the same images so we can draw together. Now, the one that I'm going to use today is a very basic one, which is just a person standing. Now, always our step one when trying to draw our person is to actually look at them. So we can tell they're standing, we can see both their feet, both their hands. They are from a frontal position, which is gonna make us a lot easier to draw this person. So to get started, we are gonna start by drawing their head. We can see their spine, shoulders, hips, legs are straight down. We can even see the shape of their legs, their feet, and their arms. Now, what's really cool is when we're looking at somebody or a picture of somebody, you can really start to see where things line up. So look at where his waist is, which is around that hip, to where those hands fall. So I can always adjust this as needed. Now that we have our bones, we need to add our muscle and our skin. So we can even start adding in those triangles to figure out those arms and forearms, our legs, so that we don't just have tiny, tiny, skinny legs. Again, those calves coming down, we can figure out where those knees are and coming down. And then we can't always see underneath, but we can kind of give a body and smooth out those neck to shoulders. We can even, if we want to, put the direction of the face. So now that we have our skin and bones, we can really start looking and drawing from observation. So I'm gonna skip the face and I'm gonna start with the actual body. So I can finish the neck, look at to where the clothing starts to come over, having those lines come all the way down, a little bit of the collar, and then we even have the blazer. So now what's nice with the blazer is we can see where the blazer comes to the waist, but also where it lines up according to those hands. So this is already giving me an idea of where things go, and I'm already noticing that my shoulders are actually gonna need to come out a little bit further. So I can look on this side also. This blazer side is a little bit closer, but it comes down to right about the same spot. And I can start to bring those shoulders out that taper down, kind of come to a point. And now I can look at that sleeve. So even though I started with those skins and bones, I might have to move that arm over because nothing is better than looking at the person that you're actually drawing. Look at how this line right here is not a straight line. Instead, it has a bend. It starts up at the seam of that. So I can add in that bend to where it comes down. I can add in the little gap here, even the double shirt. So the blazer to the actual shirt. And then again, I can move the hand over, looking at the shape of that hand. He has a piece of paper. So this is great because this is also going to help with his pants. Now looking at him and looking at this, I can see that I'm drawing a little bit bigger than what he is in this image, which means I'm probably also going to have to adjust and make those legs a little bit longer. So those knees would probably come down to right about here. Again, look at how we're making those thighs actually look like thighs. Our knee and our calf down to our ankles. Again, I'm looking at this person as I am drawing them. So I can see the pant gets skinnier. I can draw that shoe coming out with a little bit of heel on it. And then this one kind of coming forward. So I can already start to make those adjustments as needed. Now I'm gonna come back up and I'm gonna finish the side. So it tapers down to that shoulder. There's also a nice bend in this blazer that comes down to that arm also. This one has a little bit of a curve on the outside. So I'm really looking at the contour lines that I can see from my model. And again, look at how I'm gonna have to make that thigh a little bit bigger, which is only appropriate. And then we can add in the hand. Coming down, adjust that blazer, move the waist down to where I originally had it. And look how I'm making these changes as I go. So we can even add in those buttons, the other side of the top, the belt buckle. So I had the skin and the bones, and I started adding in our clothing and adding in some of that detail, like the lapels, the blazer, the actual cuff. We can go back in and start adding in where there are wrinkles on the pants, even the laces that come across on the shoes, down to the hair. And this is where it pays off, because you guys already have learned how to draw faces. So now we can add that hair in there. I gave him way too much. Now he looks like a beetle. I can even correct the face, give him some facial hair and some eyes and a nose. Now, again, we're not looking for this to be perfect, but it should resemble the person that you are drawing. So I should be able to tell which model you are drawing from our selected models. And with that being said, this is how you draw a person from observation.